क्लास 10 पे अटेंशन वी वर स्टडिंग अबाउट रॉबर्ट ईब्राइट सो व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट हिम दैट ही वाज वर्किंग हार्ड सिंस नर्सरी स्कूल व्हेन ही वाज कलेक्टिंग द बटरफ्लाइज बट हिज इंटरेस्ट वाज पुट फॉरवर्ड व्हेन ही हैज पार्टिसिपेटेड इन द साइंस फेयर ऑल्दो फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम ही वाज नॉट एबल टू विन एनी प्राइज but that was just acted as a booster for him and he has prepared the next experiment so what he has done in the next experiment in the county fair that why some of the monarch butterflies or butterflies they are being killed every year okay they thought that it was just because of beetles so he has raised some of the monarch butterflies among the beetles but he was not able to get the result but still he won the prize so next year afterwards what he has done next year when he was in grade 8 he has studied about yes why viceroy butterflies they are copying the monarchs why they copy because monarch butterflies Yes, because monarch butterflies doesn't taste good to the birds, and viceroys are the favorite food. So, in order to look like monarchs, the viceroy butterflies they would like to drive away the attention of the birds. So, when he was in his junior high school, what experiment he was carrying forward? He was studying about the insect hormone. Okay, he was studying about the insect hormone, which is responsible for the growth of the butterfly monarch butterfly so what was the viewpoint of everyone about this about the gold spots so when he was in senior year he has come out with the invention that the gold spots they secrete a special hormone what they do they secrete a special hormone which is responsible for developing of the butterfly so for that what he has done kya kiya usne he has cultured some of the cells from the wings and those cells they were able to be turned into complete winged butterfly they were able to turn into complete winged butterfly right so for that what has happened he got prize okay and he got prize and ultimately he also got opportunity Where to work? He has worked in where he worked. Yes, he has worked in Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. So afterwards, when the next year he has won the prize, he also worked in the laboratory of the U.S. Department of Agriculture. So before I start further, let me ask you about the notebooks. Who have sent? Yes. Yours is left. Next, Vineet, what about you? Today, definitely. Half your. Next. Okay, next. Next, we'll ask ma'am, what are you saying? Okay, thank God. Next one. Okay, fine. And online students also, let me ask you. Anshika, I got Baljinder, Bhavna, sent, Harjot, Kanishka, Kavish, Madhav, whosoever is left, send your notebooks, right? For checking. And this is again very important for your listening task. I will send a link to the listening task. You will listen it and perform the answers given in the Google form. Right? You will attempt, not today. Whenever it will be, I will tell you in the class one day before. Okay? So you just play the link and answer those questions in the Google form. That's it. And submit it. I will automatically get to know what you have done. Not today. Okay? Not today it will be done. So next forward, Then afterwards, when he has worked at the laboratory of the US Department of Agriculture. So next coming up, the following summer after his freshman year means first year, when the person is new to an institute or at an institute. Freshman year at Harvard University, E. Bright went back to the laboratory of Department of Agriculture and did more work on the hormone from the gold spots. So when it was his first year at the Harvard University, he again has gone back to laboratory of Department of Agriculture, where he has got a chance to work there. And then what happened? He did more work on the hormone from the gold spots. He knew that something he will find new. Using the laboratory's sophisticated instruments. Why he has gone there? Because in the laboratory, there were many instruments which were advanced. And this made his experimentation easier. And he was able to go deep into the subject. So he has gone there. He has used the sophisticated instruments there. And he was able to identify the hormone's chemical structure. So with these experiments, what he has done? He was able to formulate the structure of that hormone, which is secreted by the gold spots and which is responsible for the growth of the butterfly. So, a next year and a half later, during the junior year, E. Bright got the idea for his new theory about cell life. So, after that, what happened? A year and a half, means after 1.5 years, when he was in his junior year, he has got the idea about his new theory of cell life. It means that he has come out with his important theory of cell life, right? It came while he was looking at X-ray photos of the chemical structure of a hormone. So when he was just observing the chemical structure of the hormone. So at that time, accidentally, he came across this kind of invention and discovery. So what happened? When he saw those photos, E. Bright didn't shout Eureka. Eureka means victory. Win. Okay. E. Bright didn't shout Eureka or even I have got it. But he believed that along with his findings about insect hormones, the photos gave him the answer to one of the biology's puzzles. How the cell can read the blueprint of its DNA. So he was so poised. Poised means balanced personality. He was so patient that when he has made the discovery, which discovery he has made about the structure of the hormone. And at that time, he has come out with his theory of cell life. At that time, he did not shout. He was not overwhelmed with emotion, with joy. But what happened? He has come out to this conclusion that he has come out with the findings that how the cells, they read the blueprint of DNA. It means he has made an important discovery, and that was one of the greatest puzzles of biology. Blueprints like Xerox copy, you have the same copy. For example, when you have to make, let me tell you, in front of your books, there is given a blueprint of the question paper. Like, for example, this chapter, long questions, how many and how much marks it will carry. It is written a 1 into 2. It means, at the end, it is written 5. It means 5 marks, 2 questions. This is called blueprint. When you have a layout, okay? Then, for example, short questions, 1 into 3, which means 1 mark, 3 questions will be there. So in this manner, what is there? Blueprint is being made. Whenever you have to do anything, first of all, you have to make a blueprint of it, right? So he has come out to know that how the cell can read the blueprint of the DNA. So you know, on DNA, various kinds of components are there, okay? How they replicate, you must be knowing being a part of science student. DNA is the substance in the nucleus of a cell that controls heredity. This we all know. Heredity means? Yes, from parents to the next generation, this cycle. So, DNA is the substance in the nucleus of a cell that controls heredity. Yes, DNA, what it is responsible for copying the characters, traits, and then it is passed on to the daughter cells from the parent cell. It determines the form and function of the cell. Thus, DNA is the blueprint for life. So, because DNA is responsible for copying all the information from the parent cell to the daughter cell, so ultimately we can say that this DNA is the blueprint of life. So, E. Bright and his college roommate James R. Wong worked all that night drawing pictures and constructing plastic models of molecules to show how it could happen. So, on that night when they have discovered, when they have made this important discovery, so throughout the night, E. Bright, along with his roommate, whose name was James R. Wong. Underline this name in your books, please. James R. Wong. They have worked throughout the night. Why? Because they were drawing as well as constructing models of molecules to show how this happens. Because in order to make someone understand, you have to have a concrete form in front of you. Models, and model is the best way at that time. At this time, though, like with PPTs and with slides, you can represent your thoughts. But at that time, it was not. So, together, they later wrote the paper that explained the theory. Okay? So, finally, what they have done? They have wrote the papers. Wrote the papers means they have, they have written the information about their research. To write a paper, to read a paper, what it means? In news, you must have listened to this point that he was given an opportunity to read his paper in so and so university. What it means? Reading means existing information? No. It means delivering some important information which is not common. Okay? Writing a paper means to write about your own invention or discovery so that it will be published in journals or scientific newsletters and the information will be delivered to all related to this field. Right? So they were busy in writing papers and explain the theory. Surprising, no one who knew him, Richard E. Bright graduated from Harvard with highest honors, second in his class of 1510. So see, he graduated from Harvard, highest honors means in honors means in particular subject he has got the highest marks, and overall in the university he was second out of these many students. E. Bright went on to become a graduate student researcher at Harvard Medical School. There he began doing experiments to test his theory. So then after that, he has turned out to be a student researcher at the Harvard Medical School. And what he was doing there, he was just making various kind of experiments to prove the authenticity as well as the reality of his theory, of his cell theory that he has invented. Next, if the theory proves correct, it will be a big step towards understanding the processes of life. So he knew that if my theory will be proved right, then it would be a big leap in the field of science. This will definitely help us to chalk out the process of life, that how these processes of life, they are carried forward. It might also lead to new ideas for preventing some types of cancers and other diseases. It will also have some, you can say, curative properties also, how to stop cancer and how to treat other diseases. All of this is possible because of E. Bright's scientific curiosity. So how all this has turned out to be possible? It was just because of E. Bright's curiosity, that he was curious enough to find out the answers of all this. Yes, Raghav.
ये वाला रिपीट करना,
विच वन?
हम लास्ट पैरा।
स्पीक द पैरा सो दैट आई कैन, इफ दिस थ्योरी प्रूव्स करेक्ट और दिस वन सरप्राइजिंग, इफ द थ्योरी प्रूव्स करेक्ट दिस वन। सो he was experiment again and again based on his theory, so in order to prove that his theory was absolutely right, and if his theory is going to be proved right, he is able to find the answer to one of the greatest puzzles of biology, that how the life processes are carried on. Life processes means various functions of life, how the cells they replicate, how they copy the DNA, and how you can say multiplication of cells it takes place. So it might also lead to new ideas and for preventing some types of cancer and other diseases. This type of discovery will highly be beneficial in treating cancer and in controlling some other diseases. And all of this is possible because of E. Bright's scientific curiosity. And why this is possible? This is possible only because of the efforts that were put in by E. Bright. Right? Next, his high school research into the purpose of the spots on a monarch pupa eventually led him to his theory about cell life. This is again a repetition that in high school he has studied the gold spots, and this has led him to come to this answer that how his theory has led to the discovery of the theory of cell life. Richard E. Bright has been interested in science since he first began collecting butterflies. So this we have got to know, that since nursery class or in his lower grades, he was interested in collecting butterflies, but not so deeply that he hasn't time for other interests. But that doesn't mean that he was only a bookworm. He was only busy in his learning as well as doing experiments. He has many other interests too. See what other interests he was pursuing. E. Bright also became a champion debater and public speaker and a good canoeist. You know what is a canoe? What is canoe? C-A-N-O-E. Canoe is a boat, which are very, very narrow ones. You must have seen in races of boats, those narrow boats are used. This is called as canoe. So he was a canoeist. It means he was having the interest of sailing the boats, canoes. And he was a good debater. He participated in various debate competitions and he was the champion debater and a public speaker and all-round outdoors person. All-round outdoors, he likes to go out and enjoy the nature also. He is also an expert photographer, particularly of nature and scientific exhibits. So he loves to click photographs of nature as well as the various exhibits. Exhibits means the models that are being displayed in the exhibition. Then, in high school, Richard E. Bright was a straight A student. Means in high school, straight A means student of good grades. Because learning was easy, he turned a lot of his energy towards the debating and model United Nations clubs. So because of his efforts, learning was made easier. He was doing a lot of efforts in a particular field. And so this has happened that he has channelized his energy in debating and other competitions of model making that were part of the United Nations Club. He also found someone to admire, Richard E. Wehrer, his social studies teacher and advisor to both clubs. So this social studies teacher, he was a great admirer of E. Bright also. He was also admiring his efforts and he knew that this child is not an ordinary child. He is an extraordinary child. As he was the head of both the clubs, he was, you can say, coordinating the activities of the clubs, and ultimately under his supervision, E. Bright was working. Mr. Wehrer was the perfect person for me then. He opened my mind to new ideas. So this is a statement of E. Bright about his teacher, that his teacher has played a great role in opening his mind to new ideas, to think out of the box. Richard would always give that extra effort. What pleased me was this person, who put in 3 or 4 hours at night doing debate research, besides doing all his research with butterflies and his other interests. So Richard, Mr. Weirer is having high opinion about him. So what he says that Richard is always doing extra research for his debate topic also. And moreover, he is also putting his extra efforts in, he is also putting his efforts in the research work that he was doing. It doesn't mean that if he is doing the participating in the debate, he is only learning the facts that are provided to him. He is researching the topic on his own. But at that time, it also means, he said that he is not sacrificing his experiment work. The regular experimenting or research work that he is doing, he also carries forward that. And Richard was competitive, but not in a bad sense. He wasn't interested in winning for winning's sake or winning to get a prize. Rather, he was winning because he wanted to do the best job for he could. For the right reasons, he wants to be the best. So see what a great explanation of his personality has been given by his social studies teacher, Mr. Weirer. So what he has said that if he is participating in competition, he urges to win that competition. Just not because that he wanted to be the best, okay, but just because whatever he wanted to do, he wanted to do it in the best manner. He wanted to do it in the best way. And for that purpose, what he is doing, he was trying to do every possible effort. He's trying to put in every possible effort in order to come out with the success in particular topic. He said that he has a competitive spirit, but not in a wrong way. Not in a bad sense, but in a positive way, because he is competitor to himself only. He is providing a, you can say, next hurdle to himself only. He has set marks for himself that I have to cross it. So, that is one of the ingredients in the making of a scientist. So, what are the different ingredients in making of a scientist? Competitive spirit. To be the best, okay, to do one's best, and to be consistent, to do hard work with perseverance, right? So, start with the first-rate mind, add curiosity, and mix in the will to win for the right reasons. So, what are the main ingredients? Start with first-rate mind, positive mind, add curiosity, be curious to know the things, mix in the will to win, and then you must have the will to win the competition. And finally, you must have the right reasons to win. All these will make a great scientist. Ebright has these qualities from the time the book, The Travels of Manarchex, opened the world of science to him. And Richard Ebright has never lost his scientific curiosity. So after that, he was winning and he was doing his experiments and he has never lost his scientific curiosity, right? So this is what we have learned through this chapter. Okay, yes, finally it is over. Okay, that what actually Ebright is, it was his will to win. He wanted to win not just because for the sake of winning, but he wanted to win. Why he wanted to win? He wanted to win because he wanted to do the best job in a field. He always has set up some marks for himself that I have to cross those boundaries. And he was doing each and every effort in this direction. Right? So this is all for Ebright's story. And tomorrow we will continue with the discussion of the question answers of this chapter. Okay, if you have any doubt now, you can raise up your hands to me.